The largest shark who ever lived. This leviathan struck terror in the hearts of mammals for millions of years. Their demise was abrupt and left a huge open niche in ocean ecosystems. Could a new beast assume the role of giant killer? This is the Megalodon.
Hi, I'm Talia Lowi-Merri, and you're watching Paleologic. The Megalodon is one of the most fearsome predators of all time. If you think the great white shark is scary, this submarine carnivore will give you nightmares.
One of the things all animals share is our need for sleep. But while some animals can happily sleep 22 hours a day, I know a lot of us are having trouble getting the rest that we need. If you've been having trouble sleeping, having a hard time focusing, or suffering from stress or anxiety, you're not alone. All those factors can severely affect your productivity and mental clarity. Today's sponsor, Endel, is designed to help you relax, focus, and sleep. It takes everything we know about sound and combines it with cutting-edge technology to create personalized soundscapes to help you focus, relax, and sleep. Endel is informed by science, created with science, and backed by science. Brainwave studies show that Endel provides the fastest, most consistent focus when compared with playlists on streaming platforms. That is a result of their AI power technology adapting to circadian rhythms. Improve your productivity and focus with Endel. Plus, the first 100 people to download Endel with the link in the description will get a free week of audio experiences. Thanks, Endel. Megalodon was massive, big enough to eat whales. Some estimates put them at around 18 meters, though there's some debate about that because all we have left of them is their teeth. Like all sharks, Megalodon's skeleton was made of cartilage, which doesn't fossilize. Luckily, their teeth were made of calcium phosphate minerals, which do fossilize. So we have plenty of huge teeth to get an idea of Megalodon's monstrous size. Their teeth are the largest of any shark ever found.
And they're really, really, really big.
A mature great white shark's teeth are up to 7 centimeters. Megalodon's larger known teeth are over 20 centimeters long. Just look at how tiny great white's teeth look next to them.
Megalodon made the great white shark seem like the meh white shark. And it did for a long time.
Megalodon appeared in the fossil record around 20 million years ago, a new time for Earth where grasslands and kelp forests had just developed, and new species were thriving. From then, they gradually got larger, reaching their maximum size right before extinction, around 3 million years ago.
During their reign, there was no safe haven in the ocean, especially if you're fat and delicious.
Megalodon, like their extant cousins, ate fatty marine mammals, which, to be fair, weren't as massive as they are now. We know of this shark cetacean diet because scientists have found whale bones with shark tooth marks that could only have been made by a megalodon. One of those mammalian snacks was Piscobalaena, which was about 5 meters long. Not nearly as large as modern baleen whales, but just slightly smaller than orcas.
That's still nothing to scoff at. Killing something that big required gigantic jaws and a powerful bite.
Their mouth could be up to 3 meters wide, enough to eat you and a puma whole at the same time. Not that they would have liked you, you're probably too bony compared to their favorite snacks. Their killing strategy seemed to have been ambushing whales from below and biting off a big chunk of their guts. The whale would be dead before they even knew what bit them.
With a body made for killing giants, baby megalodons were under a lot of pressure to grow up quickly.
Studies done at the fossil sites of megalodon nurseries show that megalodon were born about 2 meters long, about the size of a sea lion, and could have reached their full size at just 25 years of age. It's unclear what they ate in their youth, but like most shark species, the competition was likely intense, and few would reach their full size. Cannibalism is relatively common in sharks, and for portions of their life, their siblings would have been the most available source of food.
It's a dangerous business being a shark. And unfortunately for this species, their chapter in the Book of Life came to an end pretty abruptly.
For such a formidable hunter to go extinct, it probably took massive changes in their environment. Changes in ocean currents caused by shifts in the tectonic plates caused major changes in the water temperatures. This likely caused krill to become less abundant in tropical waters. Several whale species went extinct, and many of those who survived moved to areas with better food supply, such as colder polar waters. Megalodon likely couldn't survive, or at least breed, in those areas. So, with not enough whales in the tropics, and a huge body requiring lots of energy, Megalodon starved to oblivion.
This was the best day ever for cetaceans, and they raved on for millions of years until humans got involved and spoiled the party.
But in just those couple million years without megalodons, whale populations exploded. New species appeared, including the amazingly huge blue whale. Without a whale-eating apex predator, there was little pressure to be nimble, and their bodies essentially became factories to turn tiny crustaceans into blubber reservoirs.
But this wasn't truly the end to megalodons' place in the human psyche. Their amazing biology has fascinated people for as long as their teeth have been discovered by beachgoers.
Naturalists and scientists have been studying their teeth since at least the 1600s. Of course, at the time, most people assumed the teeth belonged to dragons or monsters. But the similarity to great white teeth was quickly pointed out, and the myth of a living giant shark was born. The name Megalodon was coined back in 1843, and from those early teeth analyses, everyone could tell they were like nothing we'd ever seen before or since. Their teeth are still being found and sold on the internet, and even though these fossils belong in museums, many people still buy them. Though the larger teeth go for thousands of dollars, so maybe not the savviest investment.
And yet, many people still wonder if there could still be any megalodons alive in the depths of the ocean.
But don't worry, something so big would have been spotted by now. They would have to come closer to the surface to look for whales. The ocean is a peaceful place where you can go and relax and enjoy the beauty of the natural.
So what should we talk about next? Please let me know in the comments down below, and don't forget to subscribe for new episodes every week. Thanks for coming along on this journey through time. I'll see you later.